I think that when you're in an organization like the NBA that has a variety of protections that private business don't have, including sort of non-compete franchise protections, and you willingly agree to, in effect, uphold what is the image of that organization as a prerequisite to investing in it, then you have to live by the rules that you agreed to abide by. And while I understand he's going to legally challenge the forced sale, everything I read suggests that they are probably on pretty solid ground in making the case that what he did was harmful to the image of the league and therefore its success, and that he's probably going to lose. Well, I think that you have the right to express unpopular views in many situations, whether you're on a college campus or on a public street. So yes, I do think the guiding principle here that is the basis on which the league took action were the league's own bylaws that he was willingly agreeing to when he made the purchase of the team. I can't name one seminal moment where I got interested in, broadly speaking, civil liberties, including privacy and women's rights, as well as First Amendment rights. But it's certainly true that my father, through the editorials in the magazine and the Playboy Foundation, was long an activist on the issue. My mother also was very politically involved in progressive inner politics. And I think in part I chose Brandeis because it had a strong commitment to social justice and to the Brandeisian values, which certainly include, as the justice himself said, the right to be left alone. So in a way, it all kind of fed into my interests, which were very strongly law and politics when I was at Brandeis. I actually thought I would apply to the Graduate School of Law and Public Policy at Yale as what I would do professionally. And then I got a little sidetracked when my father suggested I come and work for Playboy, and I found it more interesting than I thought it would be, and then the company got in trouble and I tried to help, and then he had a stroke and I stayed, and as happens in life, it took over. But I've had the good fortune through my own work for candidates and around organizations and through Playboy to get to meet people who do extraordinary things with regard to the First Amendment, and these awards are just a part of that. Well, Glenn Greenwald is being honored for really, I think, critically important journalism in bringing to light what happens historically in a time where governments are fearful and overreach in terms of information gathering. And in fact, we will have some past winners here, and you'll hear in Glenn Greenwald's acceptance reference to past winners as part of a tradition of people who've stood up and said, wait a minute, this is wrong. So to the judges who made this selection, I think the feeling was that the issue illuminated by Glenn's work was the overarching issue in terms of the intersection of the right to privacy versus government overreach.